use your power as needed to help you get the aircraft going. Once the aircraft goes, you can pull back a little bit and just taxi, right? So now it's just left, you want to turn left, right, you want to turn right. So you see how the nose is kind of off the yellow marker?
Yeah.
You just step on the right rudder and it gets you back to center. So it's kind of like you're cycling.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, so you're going to taxi us all the way, just follow that yellow line.
Okay.
Okay.
the Hastings Lake, that's northeast sound. To Beaver Hill Lake, that'll be 6,000 feet below at Beaver Hill Lake, north end of the shore, something like over there.
Transponder, phase one. Set to alt. So you turn that until you get to alt.
And alt is alt, what?
On, and then the one above it. There,
yeah,
perfect.
What's alt?
Altitude.
Oh, altitude.
Yeah.
Okay, alt. Okay, flaps at zero.
Okay.
Okay, landing light strobes on.
Okay, we can turn on the strobes. Don't have fills. Okay, that's fine.
Strobe.
That's fine.
Beacon.
We'll
tail light.
We'll just leave the beacon on.
The lights.
Perfect.
Okay. Funny it doesn't happen, right?
Yeah.
Okay, dodge heat required?
We don't heat, we don't need.
Okay.
So, takeoff briefing. Okay, so this is where the briefing goes. So we're going to be taking off runway 28 and we're going to be going to the practice area, right? Rotation speed is?
Is?
50 knots. And we're going to be climbing out at VY, which is?
Is
67. Alright. Now, your indicator here as miles per hour and knots.
Right.
Alright. So the knots are on the outside. The inside is miles per hour.
The white.
No, so the knots are inside. Miles per hour is on the outside, right? So the outside is miles per hour. The knots are on the inside.
That's just the little numbers you're talking about?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah, okay.
Alright, so actually no. The other way around. So the outside is knots, the inside is miles. Because knots are a little bit lower than the
right
miles.
There, miles per hour.
So the miles are inside.
Yeah. Okay.
That little box is miles, the outside is knots. So this is what we're looking for, right?
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
So when you say KIS, like on
KIS is knots indicated airspeed.
Okay.
So K stands for knots. You can see up there, knots.
Yep.
And I is indicated, A is airspeed. So knots indicated airspeed.
Oh, I see.
Okay. So we're going to climb out. So I'll do the takeoff, I'll demo it. And then lesson three, we're going to try to do the takeoff.
Okay.
We'll talk you through, we'll brief it on the ground and then we'll try it, right? Okay. On the runway, check your compass heading and confirm correct runway. Okay, perfect.
Compass,
so that's good. So, we're ready for takeoff. We'll put this away. Now, you're going to taxi us to the threshold there.
Okay.
Now, the mic here, just pushing that to talk, right?
Yeah.
But I'll make all the calls today, and we'll talk about how to make the calls for our next lesson, all right?
Sounds good.
All right. So, you have control. Just a little bit of power, a little bit of right rudder here. Follow that yellow line. Ease off the brakes completely. Ease off the power. Right? So again, try not to ride the brakes.
You see
my heels?
Yeah.
They're on the floor. Completely on the floor. The toes are on the pedals.
Yeah.
Okay? Okay? Good. Now just a touch of power there. You're going to need right rudder. Yeah. And right brake on that side. Right brake. I have control, just one sec. Ease off the brake completely.
Yeah.
There we go. Alright, so have control. Rudder, follow that yellow line, left rudder, right rudder, left rudder, good.
Hey, click my traffic, this is Cessna 152, Golf Zulu, Charlie Popper, holding short runway 28, going to be backtracking and taking off 28 eastbound towards Beaver Hill Lake.
Alright, you have control, a little bit of power there, just follow that yellow line, that's good power there. Right rudder, follow this yellow line in.
On this side?
Yep. because of altitude, this is going to be a heading indicator. This is going to be a vertical speed indicator, our airspeed, and of course our turn coordinator at the bottom there. Right? Turn coordinator has the wings to tell you when you're level, and the ball to tell you whether you're skidding or slipping. Right?
Cook Line traffic, Zulu Charlie Papa, you're lining out 28 and eastbound departure 4500. Cook Line traffic, Zulu Charlie Papa rolling 28.
That's good. I'm glad you went through with me with that. start waiting back. The type is banging my head looking at the stars. Okay, I know this has got to work.
All right, we'll take up a heading of 070. Oh, okay. We might as well level off at 4,000 start off here.
Quite a few fields around there if we should have to park it.
Yeah.
Land okay. Zone.
4,000. Oh, fully rev level off here. And bring the power back to around 20. 23. And we want to trim ourselves out so that we can maintain that altitude.
Okay.
Once we've trimmed ourselves out and we're maintaining altitude, we want to lean the mixture out too. Now leaning the mixture out, you want to bring this counterclockwise so that it pulls out.
Yeah.
Until you see a drop here.
Okay.
Here we go. Just going to keep bringing this back out a little bit. And you can see it's starting to move.
Yeah,
right?
There we go.
Right? And you can go three clockwise. One, two, three. So now we're leaned slightly on the richer side of the mixture, right?
Right.
Good.
So the booklet said like a guy should check that every 15, 20 minutes, like when you're doing cross country, the mixture.
The 15, every, the thing that you want to check every 15 minutes is this guy here.
Oh yeah,
make sure it's still lining up with what you want, right? Good. Alright, so now, just going to make a quick call and let everybody know where we are, right? Maybe even gain a little bit of altitude to stay at 4,000 here.
Hey, Quick Mike traffic, Zulu Charlie Papa is 4,000 feet north of the Narrows and tracking eastbound towards Beaver Hill Lake.
Okay, good. Now, what we were talking about earlier...
We're just on the north end of Beaver Hill there, so you can take anywhere on the south.
Alright, check remarks, we'll take the south end. Thanks.
Okay, so he's in the north here, so we're going to go to the south end of Beaver Hill Lake, right?
Right.
So you want to know kind of features that can help you determine exactly where you are. This right here is Cooking Lake, right? The next lake after it is Hastings Lake. Hastings.
Hastings.
Okay. Yep. Hastings Lake, and then further down that dried up pond, that's Beaver Hill Lake.
Beaver Hill, okay.
Yeah.
Is that an airport down there, or what is that?
That's Highway 14.
Okay.
But there is a small airport right on Tarfield there, right?
Oh, okay.
So we'll see it, because we're going to the south end. Alright, so we were talking about earlier, cruise attitude, right?
Right.
So we're talking about attitudes and movements, right? And we're saying that cruise attitude is where most of the flying happens, right?
Right.
This right here is cruise. You notice we have about 4 inches from the side of the bomb or your fist to the horizon, right?
Yeah.
If you hold that steady, your altitude will stay steady.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, that's a comfortable
right. So you want to be able to identify that just by reference from outside references without looking at your instruments too much, right?
Yeah.
Now, once you know what that looks like, it's easier to set up all the other attitudes, right?
We are 5 miles. Southwest, 4,500 under Tucum.
Alright, so, here we go. Cruise attitude, we said that there was a nose up attitude and a nose down attitude, right?
Correct, yeah.
So, if this is cruise, any attitude where the nose of the aircraft is slightly higher than cruise, that's going to be nose up, right?
Yeah.
So, in order to achieve that, we need back pressure here. Just pull up a little bit, you can see the nose coming up, right? We start to gain altitude, our power drops off a little bit, and look at our speed, it starts to decrease as well, right? Then, now if we want to go back to cruise, all we have to do is ease off that, get back to that 4 inches, and we're good, right? We want to go into a nose down attitude, then a little bit of forward pressure here, right?
Yeah.
You can see how the distance here increases, right?
Yeah.
We start to descend, and our speed picks up, so does the power, right?
Right.
Good. Crew doing traffic, 172, Foxtrot Bravo,
right?
Is running up runway 28.
We're going to be able to recognize what that looks like so that we can easily set it up every time, right?
Right.
Now, those are the...